Unattainable, and I convinced myself that it was unimportant. As long as mom could do it, you know, why should I? My thoughts on the matter were changed when Hannah did a session on me using Touch for Health and GEMS. And see, when mom uses kinesiology, I must admit I kind of take it for granted. It's just something mom does, because she's amazing. And it was just something mom did. And I realized that Hannah had actually picked up the things that she had been taught in class, and that we as kids could continue to do this amazing work. When we became instructors, we thought about it and realized that we were probably the youngest Touch for Health instructors in the world. But the problem is we don't really know because we simply don't hear about the other young people in the field. Are there other instructors under the age of 20? Were the practitioners? Why don't we hear about them? It's not only that. There's also the problem of simply being difficult for a kid to get into this field of work. Even if they aren't wanting to make a job out of it, the classes simply aren't marketed to kids and teens. Hannah and I became instructors so that we could teach Touch for Health specifically to kids and teens. I don't know about you, but we really want to meet the other young practitioners around the world, because we know how cool this work is, and just how lucky we are to have it in our lives, and we want to know who else is in this little tribe of ours. For instance, here are two 11-year-olds in a Touch for Health class in Missouri, two 15-year-olds in British Columbia, and Larry told us the other day that his 8-year-old grandson can do a full Touch for Health balance, and he does have pictures, so everyone go bug Larry when we're done. And here, a bunch of dancers from a dance debut in Nova Scotia warming up together using the Meridian Dance choreography created with a few improvisations by Michelle Greenwell. Michelle says that using the Meridian Dance in dance class brings all the systems into balance before dancing, and doing it together brings all the dancers into a cohesive unit for better unison while dancing together. They have added "I love you" within the choreography, reminding each person to be in love with themselves and not critical, as many learning curves will happen in dance.
Kinesiology associations around the world have different tiers of membership, none of which are aimed at youth. Despite all the wonderful practitioners and instructors promoting SK and the association sending out newsletters, none of that information is specific to this demographic. The associations are there to give credibility and a sense of community to the people working in this field, but there isn't one for the people who need that the most, kids and teens. So the most obvious solution would be to create an association for this demographic, for the youth of the SK community, giving kids and teens support, opportunities, and a sense of place in the SK world. Now on Wednesday night, Matthew caught us up on some of the new developments and ideas in the future for Touch for Health, including some ways to support and expand our community, ways to give information to the public, to members, and encourage learning and participation even outside of class. In the conference panel, he asks, what will support the community look like in the near future? And I'm so glad you asked, Matthew, because I have an answer. I honestly could not have asked for a better introduction. I wish you had done it a little sooner so I didn't have to write my own and tell that embarrassing story. But, you know, thanks.
I'm not.
You guys have been talking for a while about getting more young people into specialized kinesiology, but it has never really happened. And since coming to this conference, it has brought my attention how much we really need this and why it hasn't happened yet. Sarah and the SWAG team have done a great job and made a great start, but we as a group need to go further, and we as the kids know how to do it.
SKY stands for Specialized Kinesiology Youth, which we frequently shorten to SK Youth or SKY. In creating a youth association that worked basically the same as the existing organizations was actually the original plan for SKY, we have decided to go in a different direction. Sorry, I lost my place. Being a part of an association requires a person to know what they are looking for, to ask a specific organization to be a member, and to pay for that service. But if you told a teenager about Touch for Health and you thought it was interesting, what's the first thing they're going to do? They're going to Google it. Uh-huh. Ask Professor Google, as Michael would say. The next generation needs specialized kinesiology just as much, if not more, than the generations before it. But if we're going to reach them, we have to be on their turf. So rather than SKY being an association, it is a website and online knowledge base. One of the things we are currently working on for SKY is a page devoted to these simple techniques that take 20 seconds to learn. Because even the simplest and easiest of the techniques taught in Touch for Health, like switch-ons and tune-ins and ESRs, are amazingly practical in everyday circumstances. Even if only a tiny percentage of teenagers that first look into kinesiology become practitioners, I strongly believe that all teenagers should know these simple techniques. Show of hands, who knew Touch for Health when they were a teenager?
Nobody.
Yeah, I know you do. Really. But not a lot, of course. Now, who would like to know, say, switch-ons, tune-ins, and ESRs when they're teenagers, ways to instantly reduce emotional stress and focus on what you're doing?
That's a better show.
That makes a big difference, doesn't it? What are the main things that stress teenagers? I'd say that's social situations, hormones, and school. There's probably a few other problems that cause a lot of stress to some teenagers, like shopping or looking hip or whatever. I don't know. I'm pretty introverted and live in a literal jungle, so I'm going to stick to what I know here. But anyways, these techniques help you to be rational about these things. I cannot possibly tell you how many times simple techniques like these have saved me from a looming homework project or similar project. Come to think of it, I'm not sure I can tell you how many times I used them while I was writing my piece of this presentation, because boy, was I nervous. Just before we came down here, we went through the whole thing, switch-ons, cross-crawls.
You missed out a whole balance out of that.
But these techniques help. Who wouldn't have their lives made better by knowing these? And who requires them more than teenagers do?
One of the big issues we personally face is in focus and procrastination. I believe this is a widespread issue in this era of technology and constant stimulation. For instance, here are all the things that we were not doing.
You guys go like this.
We were definitely writing this presentation last week, but also playing apples to apples, and writing poetry on the deck. This is how much we don't want to write this thing. This is fun. Playing at the water park.
It's like a movie montage.
This is great. I don't even, this is more apples to apples. I'm not sure what happened here. This is our second cousin?
Just some baby.
A baby we found somewhere. Modeling Kinesio Geek swag over now. I'm staring serenely into this waterfall. That's how much we weren't wanting to write things.
The watery abyss of procrastination.
But this exact lack of focus is why it's important to have concise and collected information, where you don't have to look very hard, you don't have time to get distracted between learning things. I have taken Tech for Health with teenagers and helped teach K for Kids classes. I have seen so many moms take the courses just to go home and work on their kids. And kids find this fascinating. I've seen so many kids and teens come in and out of our mom's office and have their lives better because of it. And so many times I've been able to help a friend relieve pain or stress just by using the simplest touch and health techniques. I use special ed kinesiology every day. I use touch for health every day. And sometimes I remember that not everybody is as lucky as me to have learned all this from such a young age. But Ezra and I want other kids to have that opportunity. When I took touch for health the first time, and my mom told me it was a hard class, she was right. But I had a friend take the class with me, and I had my mom and grandma there teaching it, and I was okay. But if the teacher had been someone else, I might not have reached out. I don't want to be the kid in a class full of adults. Not many people would. What kids need is an environment where they feel supported and understood, because that's how we will learn at our best. We need a classroom where a friend can take it with us, and where the teacher is relatable. And not all youth are lucky enough to have their mom teach a class. Not all even want that.
She's scared.
So we are striving for the next best thing, which is learning specialized kinesiology skills through peers and the internet. That is what's
got. This is Skype. Everything about it is targeted to a younger audience, which is exactly what makes it different from what already exists. The point is to have all the information a young practitioner might need in one place where it is easy to find. The site will be full of articles and videos to provide as much information as possible, but even more important than the pages of information is the live forum. One of the great things about being in class is the ability to ask questions, like, how would I use this in real life? Or, this crazy thing came up in session, what should I do for that? Like, if your client is asking for lizards, for whatever reason. These questions allow you to better understand the information that you are being given. But once you leave the class, you're on your own. In class, you have your teacher and fellow students who are willing to and able to help you. But in the real world, you lose that to a certain extent. Sorry about that. We wanted to give our younger students a place to continue to ask questions and receive feedback from peers and mentors, just like in class.
Trying to work in special education as a youth is hard. It's especially hard to start, because who will come to see you when there are adult practitioners around? Will you be destined to only ever work on other kids? Will anyone believe in the validity as a practitioner or instructor? And will you be able to charge money for a session? Which I understand there might be some legal things in that as well, but. These are the questions that I have always struggled with, even when our mom had an office connected to our house, full of clients who would happily have helped me practice. So I knew my credentials, and I still didn't think that anyone would take me seriously. And I think that this is the wrong mindset for us kids to be in.
The fact that a kid can take the course and come out just as qualified as an adult should speak highly of the course. Touch for Health, especially, it's a class for the layman. Even a kid can heal the world. That's a marketing poster, is what that is. Because there should be someone in every family, on every block, who knows these skills. Why shouldn't that person be a teenager? And yet we, Hannah and I, are nervous about the idea of actually going out and working on people. It requires, like, talking to people, going outside, not wearing pajamas. Yeah, it's tough. So one of our goals for Sky is not something we can give in a single article. The goal is to give these youth the confidence and the feeling of validity, and more importantly, the recognition that they need in order to do their best work. Of course, a lot of this is still vision. We're still setting up this idea, but we have so many ideas of how to make kinesiology interesting for this clientele. At one point, while we were sitting down and brainstorming content for this presentation, not procrastinating at that time, our 5-year-old brother Jorah looked up from his drawing and informed us that he was drawing an idea for a game where various organs lit up and you had to do the right correction quickly before the next organ lit up, like an anatomical Muppet game, if you will. I told you, kids find this stuff fascinating. And we brainstormed a bunch of great ideas so that we could, for what we could do to increase interest in kinesiology. But long before this, the first and best of these ideas was KinesioBot. About a year ago, I created this little animation for our mom called 14 Muscle Dance Cubed. It featured an avatar from the video game Minecraft, stylized to look like her, demonstrating a 14 muscle dance in a blocky Minecraft meadow. It was a pretty simple animation. But it took me ages to make because I was still figuring out how to animate. Also, my program is just the worst. Upon completion, I thought of how much potential this idea had. An accessible, cartoonish character demonstrating kinesiology techniques. And so I've started the KinesioBot project. The KinesioBots are unofficial mascots of kinesiology, demonstrating techniques of Touch for Health and other modalities in a fun and unique way. There are currently two models. The first one, named Princess KinesioBot, is the mascot of Alexis's business KinesioGeek, which had the awesome pants. The second one, named Skywork, is the mascot of Specialized Kinesiology Youth. I have already used Skywork to demonstrate several of the amazingly simple, yet amazingly practical techniques learned in Touch for Health on the Facebook Sky page, including switch-ons and DSRs.
Sky is still beginning, and there's so much potential. I focus most of my efforts on building the foundation of the website, while Ezra has been working as our public relations person. Maybe. Sky is not making any profits, he's not having staff. I've been doing all the web development myself. having information available and understandable, even to people who are new to the field. It seems like the Petro Health Kinesiology Association website is moving more towards this idea of providing information in one place. But it can't hurt to have more, to share resources, and to cater to this different demographic, because that's how we're going to get the most exposure. To do this, I would like to make things as simple as possible for our youth members, to make it as easy as possible. For instance, I have already started making a list of SK vocabulary, because let's face it, we use a lot of weird words.
Crazy.
And a lot of acronyms. And if I'm going to start having people asking and answering questions in a forum, I need to make sure that everyone understands what we're talking about. So currently, it is just an alphabetized list of terms, their definitions, links to find more resources, and hopefully in the future this can become a searchable dictionary. Something I'm also very excited about creating is a section I like to call What Now? This will be a detailed list of possibilities within the field, outlining what options are available to you at any given moment. Part of this is an explanation of the different roles, students, teachers, faculty, board members, and the application processes to go for all those things. So if anyone has information or resources for me on that, that would be really useful. But this kind of page would be useful to the youth and also anyone else in the SK field who is interested. The one-up section of the website will also include all the courses, ideally all SK courses, though that might still be a long way off from now. These will be the description and a link to find more information. Hopefully also cross-reference with a list of prerequisites and courses that this is a prerequisite for, so that you always know where you are, where you want to go, and how you can get there.
And equally importantly, there'll be a number of simple explanations of techniques, some of which would be easy things that we teach in K for Kids classes, switch-ons, tune-ins, the things I was talking about earlier, things that everybody should know. But we would also like to include explanations of more complex concepts, perhaps the things that people find most confusing in class and might need a refresher on. What things do your students have the hardest time on in class, touch rather otherwise?
Reactive.
Reactive.
Always
the
reactive.
That's the one. Reviewed it so many times, still not sure I understand.
These are things that would be nice to have an explanation somewhere online, as well as maybe a video of someone teaching it, so it's different than the description in your manual.
Well, some of these things should be available to everyone. Some of them, like reactives, are harder concepts. We should be limited to the people who know how to use them. You do not have to be a member on skyouth.org in order to access this information. There should be information available to everyone there. You do have to be a member in order to contribute to the forums, to see other member information, and to see research content, which would be things like reactives. So when someone registers to be a member of SKY, they have to fill out a form, which one of us then has to review and approve. And one of the questions on the form is, what is your relationship with kinesiology? To which you have a few options. Can be a student, an instructor, or just interested in learning more. There's another option on how to become a mentor, but I will be talking about that more in a moment. For registration, members have this role as a mentor, instructor, student, or interested in. And this makes it very easy to find people within the member directory, as they are listed by their roles, and very easy to then restrict access to content. This is the member directory as it currently stands. There are very few people in it, but there are some people in it, even though the website is not doing anything, which means we must be doing something right. That, or I yelled at everyone until they signed up. You don't know.
She's scary too.
But these are the people who will be taking your job someday, so be nice. Mentoring and the importance of that, and some ways we can do that. And I would like to add one more thing to that list. Becoming a mentor on SKY teaching K for Kids classes or doing small SP demos just to get exposure, right? The purpose of kinesiology is to help other people, and the best way to do that in any field is by giving them information. So let's inform the next generation so they can heal the one after. I asked the kids I know in Touch for Health to answer this question. Why do you love Touch for Health or Touch for Health classes? I got some lovely answers. It's my first aid kit that will always help me avert so many real life situations. Most people just love having the practice time, way to share hope and healing, way to heal myself. These are amazing things, and they help adults and these kids.
I put together a little something for the end of the presentation.
Aww.
I really hope this works. I was finishing touches on it last night, so bit of a rush job. Anyway, those are the things kids love about Touch for Health, and we're going to give them one more. Presenting Skywork. Who wants to do their switch-ons? Anybody? Stand up. And Hannah, well, there we go.